twice a day as well, just to make sure that the inflamed tissue wouldn't that the inflamed tissue wouldn't get infected and that it would heal nicely.
Hey guys, so as many of you who have been following us lately will know that Momo recently had a bit of an abscess on his forehead, so we thought we would just tell you the story and what went on and so on, and maybe also how you can, or what you can look out for to check if your cat might have an abscess as well.
Where do we start? When was it?
At the beginning. So I think two weeks?
Not
was it that long?
No.
A week ago or so, we noticed Momo had a bit of a bump on his forehead.
It kind of appeared from one day to another, and that's one of the main criteria for abscesses, is that they tend to, because they come from cat bites most of the time. So cat teeth have a lot of bacteria on them, and therefore a cat bite specifically is very likely to turn into an abscess. So, but they're very difficult to see because they're basically just a small little puncture, and under all that fur, you won't necessarily notice it until the abscess has formed. So that's what happened with Momo. We hadn't, even though it was on his head, we hadn't noticed anything out of the ordinary. And eventually, one morning, Toby actually picked him up and showed me, and he was like, listen, he has a little bit of a bump on his head. And then I split the fur and I could see that there was very clearly one pink, reddish, like crusty dot in the middle. And then the bump had formed around it. And I'd seen abscesses in cats before because my mom's cat tends to fight. He's the only one who leaves the property and goes and does naughty things. So we know what to look out for. So immediately, because it was a Friday, I didn't want to leave it because it was over his eye as well, which is obviously a sensitive area. So I took him to the vet that morning and they basically shaved the area and they said we caught it very, very early, so there wasn't a lot of pus or anything in the wound yet. So all they did was basically open the wound up a little bit, drained the pus and left it open so that it would be allowed to heal. And they gave us antibiotics to give him twice a day for 5 days, and they gave us some cleaning liquid to just dab the wound with, or not really spray onto the wound, but drip onto the wound twice a day as well, just to make sure that the inflamed tissue wouldn't that the inflamed tissue wouldn't get infected and that it would heal nicely. So we were quite lucky because we caught it very early. It wasn't really nasty. I've seen some much, much worse ones on my mom's cat. Abscesses can be really, really scary, and they are to be taken seriously because when they're closed, they were also, depending where they are, Nino, my mom's cat, had one on his leg once, and we actually just noticed that the entire leg was swollen, and that's why we took him to the vet. And only after the vet had shaved the paw did he and touched it did he realize that there was actually the little puncture wound on the leg. And that one had run, because it's on the leg and it's a very thin area, had run quite deep, and it was actually like the pus was all around the muscle, which was quite bad. So there, in that case, they had to shave the entire leg and they opened it up, and it was a really quite a big, I would say probably about 1 centimeter big hole, diameter hole in his leg. And we could see the movement of the muscles underneath, which was really, really gross and quite scary to see. So it is something to be taken seriously. They're also, cats tend to get fevers because of the infected tissue. So antibiotics are a must. So never, I know that there's a lot of things, recommendations on the internet that you can do warm presses and there's some home remedies. I would definitely not recommend that because cats are also very good at hiding pain. And by the time you actually notice that your cat is taking a corner, it might already be too late, or it might be very serious at that stage. So if you ever notice that your cat may have an abscess, or you suspect he may, I would say immediately take them to the vet. Just rather be safe and get the antibiotics, make sure that the abscess is drained properly, and obviously then make sure the cat stays indoors until it's healed and that everything is looking great. So we did let him go out into the garden because we know he's supervised. He can't go anywhere. Our backyard is very, very safe. We know he doesn't know how to get out. So there was no risk for him to be in the garden. And because we were disinfecting the wound twice a day, there was also no risk of anything getting into it.
We're not entirely sure where he got it. I assume he bothered one of the other girls and they
probably just bit him. But the vet did say that the bite wound was also not very deep, and that's why it wasn't so bad. So obviously it was probably in play or just a little bothersome, and they bit a little bit harder than they usually would to get him to back off. Whereas Nino, you can tell it's from fighting because they're really deep abscesses and they're usually very big ones as well on him. But Momo has recovered very well. He's already, I think it's been just over a week now because it was last Friday probably. The scabs have basically fallen off most of the space. There's just one spot that still has where it was the deepest, and I think that's the original bite wound. His hair unfortunately hasn't grown back yet. That's gonna take a little while, but he did very well. He was okay with being pilled. We just had to catch him by surprise, and he was quite patient with it all, and he bounced back very quickly. I actually, as I said in a few of your comments, I think he was more traumatized by the fact that he had to go to the vet and be in the carrier than he was by the actual abscess. So we were quite lucky in this case, and we just wanted to chat to you guys about it so that you're warned that abscesses can be quite serious and what to look out for.
Yeah, look, we're very lucky that all of our cats stay in the property except for Nino, obviously. So they do have the freedom to be outdoors, but if possible, I think try and keep your pets indoors or in a confined area if you can. I know it's not always possible and you want to allow them that outdoors freedom, but with that outdoors freedom comes the risk of these kind of things happening,
including as well being bit by wild animals, never mind other cats. Getting into fights, getting attacked by dogs, getting hit by cars. There's obviously a lot of dangers out there. But we know sometimes it isn't possible. We've really, with Nino, we have tried everything to cat-proof the yard in the areas where he leaves. But he's like a little Houdini. He will find a different way. And I mean, you can see we're taking it seriously because none of the other cats can get out. It's just him. He is so athletic and he can jump higher than all the others. He can climb better than all the others. And I think the more we try to keep him in, the worse it's getting, because then he will eventually like really make a fuss. So we've kind of accepted that with him, it is what it is. And he does, the one thing we do is we lock him in at night to try and minimize the amount of fights he gets in, because cats tend to fight at night more than anything else. So when we feed him dinner, we lock him in and we keep him inside until the morning, and then he's only out of the property during the day. So that has limited the amount of injuries he's come home with. So if you can keep your cats in a safe backyard, in a cat safe backyard, or get a catio, that would be quite an option, because I know they love being outdoors, but it's not necessarily safe for them.
Well, anyways, guys, that was just a quick little video just to update you on what's been going on with Momo. A lot of you have been asking in the comments just to see how he's doing. We've also got a lot of well wishes and so on. We're really grateful for your support and your interest in Momo. We really love hearing those kind of things from you. So keep dropping those comments.
If you have had any experience with abscesses, please let us know. We also really enjoy reading the stories of your cats.
And then please share the video with your friends. And I hope this made you a little bit aware of the worries that might come with getting an abscess, or
just inform you.
Yeah. Anyways, we'll check you in the next one. Cheers.
Bye.